Today we celebrate 100 years of Total Power Initiatives in the Bay of Fundy, and we're also today celebrating the opening of the Acadia Total Energy Institute at Acadia University.
It's an opportunity for students to address a real problem, learn the skills about doing that research along the way, and really to build their own careers, which may take them anywhere in the world.
Welcome to the official opening of the Acadia Tidal Energy Institute. My name is David McKinnon. I'm Dean of Research and Graduate Studies, and I have the privilege of serving as your host this afternoon.
In the 1970s, attention turned not from the outer part of the Bay of Fundy, but to the upper part of the bay. 1984, we had the opening of the building of the Annapolis Tidal Power Station. Now, you'll notice on this timeline, if you can see it well enough, that I've outlined two of those dates or events in yellow, the Clarkson one in 1915 and the present work in Minas Basin and Digby Passage, because they are different from the tidal power proposals of the past in that they depend upon the free flow of water rather than the impounding of water as in a hydroelectric station. We created an organization called the Fundy Environmental Studies Committee. It was an association of university researchers, government agents, and the private sector to try to understand what the effect of building large-scale barrages would be.
The research focus areas that we have now at Acadia extend beyond the research areas that we had in the past that Graham mentioned, the ecological studies. We now have faculty involved in more of the physical mathematical modeling side of things, looking at energy resource assessment, which is critical for developers to have an understanding of. And also other faculty who are involved on our team who are looking at some of the socioeconomic considerations in finance and dealing with sustainable communities. And right now we have underway a big collaborative project that's spanning pretty much every discipline you can think of, is the development of a business and community tidal energy toolkit, which is supported by many people and many organizations. We are looking for partnerships in tidal energy research and training and in the development of sustainable communities, and these come from these four sectors: research centers, universities and colleges, industry, government, NGOs, and community groups. Thank you.
We're delighted today to have with us the Honorable Peter McKay, Minister of National Defense and member for Central Nova, and I think I can say proud Acadia graduate. Welcome back, Mr. Minister.
Dr. Reddy, Mr. Dempsey, Mr. Woods, this is a wonderful and extraordinary project that has quite a history, as we've heard. Today, this province is home to one of only three tidal power plants in the world. And now, through Acadia's Tidal Energy Institute, the only one of its kind in North America, researchers with expertise in oceanography, marine ecology, and economics, to name but a few, will be gathering here to place a collaborative effort in building a stronger, sustainable tidal energy sector and future for our region and the world. And to everyone here at the Acadia Tidal Energy Institute, I congratulate you on your hard work and progress so far. I can't wait to see the next chapter for this exciting story. Thank you.
Tidal energy development is also a priority for the province. We see it as a key to clean, secure energy and also a way to boost local economic development and to provide local expertise in supplying a global industry. We are calling upon the greatest minds in Nova Scotia's ocean sector in carving our path to move from the research and development stage to the commercial production of marine renewable energy in our province. And we look forward to the continual work that is happening here at Acadia. Thank you very much.
Anna and her colleagues, Richard Kirsten, Shelley McDougall, John Colton, and Graham Dearborn, deserve enormous credit because it's not easy, even in an academic environment, to do these kinds of things. My personal history with the Bay of Fundy goes back a lot of generations. My ancestors found their way north to the shores at a place that for a long time was known as Ogilvie's Wharf, down the other side of Harborville, now simply is shown as Ogilvie on the map of Nova Scotia. We in Atlantic Canada, and here particularly in Nova Scotia, have the opportunity to have the world's largest single source of green energy through the energy that can come through the Churchill, the energy from natural gas, one of the cleanest sources of energy there is, tidal energy of enormous power. We can have that source here, the largest source of green energy in North America. Thank you, congratulations, and thank you so much for the opportunity to be here.
Minas has always cherished its relationship with Acadia. Acadia has been a dear friend. As expected, Acadia engaged in our project in just about every way, and after 4.5 years, the university has created an international reputation for mathematical modeling, scientific know-how, and coastal community development. Acadia University must be congratulated for fostering camaraderie among university, government, and private sector scientists. The fact that hundreds of local and national scientists are working together towards a common goal to ensure a responsible and proactive extraction of Fundy tidal energy does not happen without credible leadership. Acadia University is indeed that leader. On behalf of Minas Basin Pulp and Power and the Fundy Ocean Research Center for Energy, congratulations to Acadia University for establishing yet another milestone in this wonderful, wonderful story of tidal energy from the Bay of Fundy. Thank you, Acadia University.
Acadia University, Cape Breton University, St. Evex, St. Mary's and Dalhousie, all working in a collaborative fashion to answer the fundamental questions that deal with how can we as a society extract in a responsible fashion the power that exists in our offshore energy resources. Because let's not kid ourselves, if we don't do this in a responsible way, we will lose our social license. We may have a regulatory authority, but if we don't maintain in a very responsible fashion our social license, then all of this will be for naught. And I believe research is at the heart of our being able to maintain that. Thank you.
Great day for Acadia University. It's a great day for rural coastal communities in Nova Scotia and for the sustainable energy community around the world. Rapid changes in atmospheric composition, landscape configuration, and climate, resulting largely from a voracious and rapidly growing appetite for carbon, have disrupted ecological processes, leading to the loss of habitats and species, and more importantly, the loss of evolutionary potential. In short, we have some heavy shifting to do. If we are to transition to a sustainable post-peak oil world, presumably with carbon neutrality as a central feature, we need to get beyond our ARC mentality. We need to recognize that resistance is futile and start modeling resilience. And we need to address the real debt crisis, which of course is ecological and extinction debt, and seek a resolution. The Institute marks a significant step in doing just that. Thank you all for coming today. I suppose it is up to me to announce officially, to declare officially that the Acadia Tidal Energy Institute is now open. Congratulations.